Over the past 4 years, Mississippi State has been the toughest team in the SEC West. No one else in the division has won more games than the Bulldogs. And no quarterback has more wins in school history than senior Wayne Madkin. Last year, Wayne and the Bulldogs took a bite out of the Gators, becoming the first unranked team to beat Florida in the Spurrier era. Now they look for their first win in Gainesville since 65. The Gators love the comforts of the swamp. They've lost only two SEC games at home since Steve Spurrier arrived more than a decade ago. This year, the man at the helm is sophomore Rex Grossman, who's coming off three straight 300-yard passing days. He's kept the fun in the Florida offense and has Gator pride running high. Papa John's College Football Today is next on CBS.
Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Brando, and welcome to Papa John's College Football Today. Here in our new digs at Studio 43, coming up, Home Depot SEC on CBS, number 21, Mississippi State, against second-ranked Florida. Now, the Gator offense is running on all cylinders. Florida has the top-ranked passing attack in the nation, but they might just meet their match. Mississippi State is number one in the nation in passing defense. I'm joined now by Spencer Tillman. And you know what? I'm looking at this game and I'm thinking, wake up the echoes of Danny Werfel at 96, because Rex Grossman may be playing the best at that position for Steve Spurrier since Werfel did it and they won the national
title. You're absolutely right, Tim. I spoke to Steve Spurrier early this week and he was ecstatic about his performance at quarterback right now. Statistically, Steve Spurrier said that this guy has a chance to be the best he's ever coached. And that's saying a lot with Werfel and the likes. We can go down the line. That's pretty impressive. Of all the errors he thinks he can improve, however, it's checking off at the line of scrimmage. You said in the open, he had the 300-yard games working so far, even though those were some pillow fights.
Well, remember in 96, though, Werfel also had Riedel Anthony, Ike Hilliard, had Fred Taylor as a running back. Now, the run-pass balance isn't where it was in 96, but it could be there with guys like Graham and Gillespie. And against a team like Mississippi State, Spencer, I'll suggest to you they had better run the ball more effectively.
You bet. That's a very fascinating statistic, but I think the thing you look at, Tim, and it doesn't take in consideration, is the fact that you have to understand the defenses that you're playing. Some teams require you to pass more against them. Some teams require you to run more against them. I think you're going to see with Joe Lee's Dunn's defense, that 5-1-5 attack, he's going to bring pressure big time. So they've got to have effective ground game working. When you look at their pressure from last year, it is evident. Pressure comes from all over the place. It comes from the outside of the perimeters. You got to be able to deal with it. Here, it's right up the gut, up the middle. Quarterbacks got to be maneuvering. When they're effective, they're able to flush deep out of the pocket. That causes some errant passes, and all of a sudden, you're snapping the ball over your quarterback's head, trying to create something happen. Good things usually never happen in those situations, Tim. So Florida has got to be able to stand the test of that pressure on Joe Lee Dunn's defense.
From an offensive standpoint, Mississippi State has struggled. One thing we need to mention, we just got this word from our remote crew on site. DeCenzo Miller is dressed, but we don't expect him to be running the football today because of injury. And because of that, Mississippi State could be in a world of hurt because this young man was very effective last year.
Had a record performance, 172 yards. That's best. His running mate, also Dante Walker, had 156. So stellar performance by both those guys. That means that if one of them's out, that production is going to have to be made up by this guy, Wayne Madkin. He's the type of guy that's not particularly flashy, Tim. However, he has more tenure than any other SEC quarterback. 24-11 are his numbers as a starter. That's pretty solid performance.
Yeah, their offense has really struggled. Obviously, Madkin had a number of drop passes against South Carolina last week. Speaking of South Carolina, other SEC games that are very important. Alabama right now beating the Gamecocks. A number of turnovers in this game for South Carolina early on. And Alabama quarterback Tyler Watts running well, plunging with the option look for an 8-yard score. That made it 20-10. And then Carolina quarterback Phil Petty connects a little swing pass out to Ryan Brewer, the youngster from Ohio. On the screen, goes for the 9 yards and the score, 23-17. But again, Tyler Watts running the option. Now, this is South Carolina defense that ought to be able to handle that. They see quite a bit of that package in their practices every day. But right now, Alabama getting it done. Remember, LSU has to play Tennessee this week, Florida next week. Mississippi State could be losing their second. Those were the favorites in the West. Alabama could be a sleeper here.
Yeah, if I'm Dennis Franchione, I'm telling my ball club, keep your dauber up. Yes, indeed, we do have a loss to a strong UCLA team as as it turns out, but that's a non-conference loss. The key is Alabama has a chance to get back in this thing.
Well, in terms of marquee games around the country, there's no bigger game than Kansas State and Oklahoma. And right now, the Sooners only leading by 8 in a game they really needed to be impressive in, 35-27. They're looking to leapfrog Miami and looking to leapfrog Florida from a BCS perspective. They needed a dominating win against Kansas State. They're not obviously going to get that.
Tim, I don't think you'll see it, because part of the reason why the BCS was tweaked a little bit this year was because of the sentiment of the team in front of them. That would be Miami. I don't think Oklahoma has enough to leapfrog Miami for the number one or number two spot. So look at, hey, yeah. Oklahoma's just got to win big.
By the way, there are some teams that are struggling like Oklahoma did a few years ago under John Blake. How about Penn State? They're now becoming a really good homecoming opponent in the Big Ten. Iowa loading up against Joe Pa's team. First and goal from the Penn State, well, 8-yard line. And again, it's Kyle McCann dropping back, hitting his receiver, Khalil Hill, in the end zone. Hawkeyes leading 21-5 at that point. Then Zach Mills caps off an 18-play drive, gets it to Brian Johnston. But the reality is, Penn State is really struggling offensively and defensively.
Tim, when you start looking at futility marks, there are 115 Division I-A schools. Penn State and Happy Valley, they're not too happy. They are dead last in offensive production. So Joe Pa's got a major issue on his hands.
They could go 0-3 for just the second time under Paterno. Well, Notre Dame has never gone, I repeat, never gone 0-3. They play in College Station today against the Aggies. And boy, Nebraska had their way against Notre Dame. It's tough to start there. But the Fighting Irish have made a change at quarterback now. Lavecchio has been benched. But Bob Davies' team has struggled really since the Oregon State loss in the Fiesta Bowl. They won 9 games last year. They look to be a shell of that team.
And they ran off several straight. Remember when we were talking about Matt Lavecchio, even though he didn't start this game, he was the guy that provided some stability for them, had all kind of consistent numbers near the stretch. They've got to get this thing righted or they're going to be in big trouble.
All right, we've talked about the bad and the ugly. How about the good in college football to this point in the season? Well, the report card reads A for undefeated Fresno State, cracking the AP top 10 last week. I actually voted them fourth. I think David Carr has become a Heisman hopeful. The fly in the ointment, the poster child for the have-nots of college football in the wild, wild whack. Folks, they've gone in the Big 10 and 1, Big 12 and 1, Pac 10 and 1. The schedule in the whack means they're going to be favored in all of their games, but Louisiana Tech is a tough out, as is Colorado State. This is a team that conceivably could get to one of the BCS bowls. Not the national championship in the Rose Bowl, but one of them.
Come on, Tim, you know as well as I do the way they've tweaked the BCS this year, those quality wins that they had against Wisconsin and those likes, not going to matter because it's where you end up in terms of stats as opposed to where you started out.
That's why they can't play in the Rose Bowl, but they could play in one of the BCS bowls. Now, when we come back, we'll get you caught up on more of today's action, including a look at how Big Red and the Big Ten did today when Papa John's College Football Today returns in a moment.
Papa John's College Football Today is sponsored by Papa John's Pizza. Better ingredients, better pizza.
So, how's the food here?
Great, Mom. Pizza every day.
That's what I was afraid of.
Oh, it's not what you had in college, Mom. It's Papa John's.
But you need variety.
Variety? I get it with Papa John's thin or original crust, great fresh veggies, and 100% meat toppings. And right now, a large two-topping Papa John's pizza is only $9.99. Plus, a second large two-topping pizza is just $4.99. I'm living better than I ever did at home.
Point, shoot, create. The HP Digital Photo Studio, featuring the Pavilion 7970 with the Intel Pentium 4 processor. How will you use it? Save up to $250 by mail on HP Digital Photography products.
AOL is all I need.
I've got a brand new grandson.
I still have a younger brother in college. I email him a lot.
Very easy to use.
Instant messages are amazing.
I love hearing.
You've got mail.
AOL is really quick.
America Online has new music.
I feel like a part of a community with AOL.
She's always on AOL.
Customer service has been superb.
I love AOL.
America Online, so easy to use, no wonder it's number one. Call 1-800-4-ONLINE.
You like simple better than complicated. You like quick better than slow. You like easy better than hard. So now pay with SpeedPass at both Exxon and Mobil. It's fast, it's free, and it links to a check card or major credit card you already have. Call toll-free or visit speedpass.com. We're drivers, too.
It's amazingly clear. It's multifunctional. High-definition television from Samsung. It's a world of clarity, and everyone's invited. Come to Sears every Saturday to see a live broadcast of college football in high definition.
We can turn this place around!
Craig T. Nelson in the season premiere of The District, CBS Tonight. Meet the new survivors. Diane, the mail carrier. Silas, the bartender.
If it means kicking somebody when they're down, I'll do it.
Survivor Africa premieres CBS Thursday, October 11th.
Programs, know the names, know the game. Programs, $4. All right, programs.
Sir, peanuts, salted or unsalted peanuts. Got your peanuts here. There you go. What?
Every Saturday, come see how different college football looks on HDTV at Sears. Where else?
Interesting look now at the latest Sportsline Top 10 fan poll. The Vols slipped to 10, followed by Fresno State. Oregon and Washington are at 7-6. Little movement in the middle. I think Texas is perhaps overrated. Maybe you'll consider that in your next voting. Sooners are 2. Once again, Miami, number 1. Now, remember, you can log on to vote in next week's poll at cbs.sportsline.com or AOL keyword CBS Sportsline. We need to update you now at Williams-Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina. Update that score. Spencer, is this you running this broken wing tee that Lou Holtz has got going on?
It looks like it. It's a little truncated bone. That's Andrew Pennick going in for the touchdown. It looked familiar, doesn't it?
Yeah, plenty of time left in this game. Gamecocks looking to win at home. They already have 2 road victories for Lou Holtz, so that still plenty of time left in that game for the Gamecocks. Elsewhere in the SEC, Ole Miss, a real coming out party for Eli Manning. They just scored again as we speak, and this young man has tremendous talent. Does he remind you a little bit of Peyton here?
Yeah, he does. Look at the patience he shows going up top. Look at the eyes. One direction and back the other way, Tim.
And Chris Collins, outstanding receiver. Rayford is another. They got some speed merchants there. Kentucky wearing blue helmets. According to Tony Neely, their SID, I spoke with him a few moments ago for the first time in history. And Shane Boyd, the 240-pound option-oriented quarterback who took over for Jared Lorenzen, gets in. But the Rebels have just scored to make it 28-14. Now, in top 10 action today, the Cornhuskers against Missouri, 22-3 as they open the fourth in this game. Patriotism, number of teams playing for their first home game since the tragedy. On fourth and goal from the 2, Crouch uses the option play, and Daron Diedrich rushes it in for the score, makes it 7-3. And then on first and goal from the Missouri 5, they get it done yet again, and the Huskers are rolling right along as we open the fourth, 22-3 the score there. Elsewhere, Virginia Tech and Central Florida, the Hokies managing to get it done in a very big way.
How about the little surprise action here? Ryan Schneider, a little throwback play action in that sweep. He's going to come all the way back, find his receiver in the corner of the end zone. Nice little nifty play there for a touchdown. And then here's one half the replacement for Lee Suggs. That's Keith Burnell bouncing it in for a touchdown, a little base play. And then the talented freshman, Kevin Jones, he's going to go up to the middle, but watch him bounce it outside, showing us a little talent there. Had him up 17-7 in the second quarter at that point.
Well, Virginia Tech's record for shutting out opponents in quarters will come to an end, but the number 8 Hokies still rolling against the Golden Knights today. Into the Big Ten, Michigan State, Northwestern, very important game there. 17-14, T.J. Duckett, 98 yards on the afternoon. Both these teams harboring hopes of making it to pass, well, making it into a BCS bowl, obviously, by winning the Big Ten. Purdue and Minnesota, 28-25. The Golden Gophers in what has been a track meet today.
Making them forget about Drew Brees. Hey, if you're going to play Joe Tiller's offense, you got to have a little fun. How about the little throwback here, huh? Brandon Hans pitching it back. His back, Montrell Lowe. Hans runs it out to the left, throws back. Hey, that's nice. That's how you do it. Had him up 14-7. And then Tellus Redmond takes it in from a short gainer in for the touchdown. Minnesota coming back. That tied it at 14. Then the nifty little trickery there from the 1-yard line gives Minnesota the advantage. 28-25.
Yeah, but they're down. They usually get 82 points between the two teams in this matchup. Joe Tiller's offense, a lot of teams in the Big Ten picking it up now. Ohio State up on Indiana. That's found a final now, 27-14. And a lot of good work done today. Yes, painted faces abound. On first and goal, Ohio State tailback Liddell Ross takes the handoff up the middle, makes it 10-7 in the first. Antoine Randall L. had a big day with running back Le'Veon Williams, a little play fake. The Indiana quarterback breaks an NCAA Division 1A football record as being the first quarterback to run for 3,000 and pass for over 6,000 yards. Then on first and goal, Ohio State tailback Jonathan Wells gets it in. Buckeyes lead it 27-14, so Randall L. gets a record, but drops one, and they're now 0-3 overall. East Carolina and Western Kentucky and Wisconsin, 10-3 the score in that game. The Badgers, Barry Alvarez's defense, the difference so far against the Hilltoppers. That's in the second. Now, the Orangemen of Syracuse coming off a very important win, non-conference against Auburn last week.
Well, somebody must have slipped Troy Nunes and that Syracuse offense some no-dos. They finally came up big here. How about the big long ball? Jamel Riddle, the receiving end of that one, 38-yard score, had him up 6-3. They missed the point after the touchdown. And then the Orangemen increasing that lead, 13-3 here. That's Jeremy Frazier on the 4-yard touchdown run.
Well, remember, R.J. Anderson had the flu, could not play, so that forced Nunes into action. Coming up, I'll look at Gator coach Steve Spurrier, who tried to take all of the flaws out of this Florida football team. He always has plenty to say.
We strive to play as perfectly as possible, and I just think that's what all people that are champions strive for.
Papa John's College Football Today continues after this.
It's amazingly clear. It's multifunctional. High-definition television from Samsung. It's a world of clarity, and everyone's invited. Come to Sears every Saturday to see a live broadcast of college football in high definition.
Across a digital gridiron, gladiators collide, one-on-one, bid against bid. This is UBID, where you win at paying less for thousands of brand names. Like an HP Pavilion 7970 with the Intel Pentium 4 processor, the center of your digital world. Most bids start at $9, and guts equals glory. Win at UBID.com or click on auctions at CBSSportsLine.com.
When Hank Aaron played in the minors, he batted cross-handed, left hand over right. When a scout suggested he try it the other way, Aaron flipped his hands around and proceeded to hit 3 home runs in his very first game. And of course, a few more after that.
Hey, nothing beats an original. Original Coors, brewed with Rocky Mountain water.
Original Coors, it's all in the wrist.
In my family, if one wants pizza, the other wants Chinese. Even their stomachs don't agree. If one gets indigestion, the other one gets heartburn. If one gets nausea, the other one gets... Well, so I get Pepto-Bismol. As it coats, it relieves heartburn, indigestion, upset stomachs, nausea, and diarrhea. It'd take a box full of other medicines to do what Pepto-Bismol does. Agree?
Agree.
Pepto-Bismol, first aid for heartburn, diarrhea, nausea, indigestion, and upset stomachs.
Where's my butcher?
And where is my baker?
Where's my wax-fingered candlestick maker?
Where is my lawnmower?
And where's my blender?
Where is my outdated
chrome-plated
used car fender?
Where is my mover? Where is my shaker?
Where
is my tawny
brawny
leaf raker?
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it on switchboard.com. The free online yellow pages with businesses, people, and products nationwide. Even links to websites and more. Switchboard.com. It's the yellow pages electrified.
Point. Shoot. Create.
The HP Digital Photo Studio, featuring the Pavilion 7970 with the Intel Pentium 4 processor. How will you use it? Save up to $250 by mail on HP Digital Photography products.
Florida head coach Steve Spurrier, the only major college coach in the 20th century to win 100 games in his first 10 years at a school.
Just the mention of Spurrier's name conjures up to all types of images, a quirky genius, an arrogant competitor, or simply an unapologetic winner. Whatever you think of him, he's living up to the high standards he's set for himself and for Gator football.
You don't have to look on the field to see how Florida is playing. Just check out the sideline. There, an intense Steve Spurrier accepts nothing short of perfection.
He backs it up, talks the talk, and walks the walk.
Now, Steve, I mean, he is confident, you know, and he displays that confidence.
You know, sometimes people are born and love to compete and love to play games. Gosh, I remember a pickup basketball game was as important as who won or lost as maybe a conference SEC game.
Spurrier's confidence was born more than three decades ago on the very same field he now spends Saturday afternoons. In 1966, he led the Gators to a 9-2 season, capturing the highest individual honor in college football, the Heisman Trophy. It's enough to make anyone a little cocky.
That's today's paper?
But those old headlines weren't enough to please Spurrier.
I was never accused of being the most competitive guy when I was a player, to tell you the truth. I look back, wish somebody had been tougher on my butt and yelled and screamed at me a little bit, and maybe I would have been a better player, to tell you the truth.
Pull back, pull back! Come on, Billy, hit!
Now in his 15th college season, Spurrier comes across as a man who can't seem to enjoy success.
I think the image that most people have of him is what they see on game day, which is him sort of fiery and emotional. And he's just not that high-paced all the time.
He's not trying to improve his image. He's a very wonderful, caring, compassionate, funny person.
Family vacations. We're going to stop once for gas, we're going to get it, and we're going. If you got to go to the bathroom, you need to go now, or when we stop for gas.
And the Gators have won the national championship! The Florida Gators! Greatest moment in Gator football history!
Spurrier has achieved legendary success, leading Florida to six SEC championships in 11 seasons. He bristles at the critics who gloss over the substance to attack his style.
Winners admire and respect other winners, and losers try to find something negative to say about winners. I really admire and respect those people that are consistently successful year after year.
Steve will say something that'll make you mad, you know, and I think that's where a lot of the noise comes from. But Steve's, I think he's a heck of a dang guy.
He won't compromise what he believes in, and he's been successful everywhere he's been, and so now the players believe him. Steve Spurrier says it must be the Bible.
Hopefully, I don't need a lot of outside praise, and I'm not going to coach as long as Bear Bryant or Johnny Vaught or Vince Dooley or those guys. Nobody hardly lasts 24, 25 years anymore. So hopefully, we will accomplish a lot in the years that I coach, and every year is a new year, and that's really the only thing I try to concern myself with.
Yeah, I think it's fair to say that anybody that's had any contact with Steve Spurrier would certainly suggest he marches to the beat of a distant drummer. But one thing we can say, Timmy, no coach has done more in a shorter period of time as Steve Spurrier.
Yeah, his numbers are bear-esque. I think of him, compulsive competitive syndrome.
That's fair.
You heard that bite in there. You said maybe if I had gotten somebody that yelled at me a little bit more. He's still playing. See, he's a coach on the sidelines, but inside, I really think he's having an out-of-body experience with his quarterback.
I agree. I think that's fair.
All right. We'll be back with more after this message and a word from your local station. Mississippi State is warming up. We're about 11 minutes away from kickoff in the Swamp.
Brian Denny, Mary Stuart Masterson, Three Blind Mice, CBS Sunday.
Now we'd like to welcome a new station to the CBS family of affiliates. A big hello to WVSX in Lewisburg, West Virginia, CBS Channel 59. Now we have a few scores we need to update you on. Purdue, Travis Dorsch has just kicked a 48-yard field goal to tie this game at 28 at the Hubert H. Humphrey Metrodome. So they're headed to overtime in that particular Big Ten matchup. Joe Tiller obviously pretty pumped. Elsewhere, Ole Miss in Kentucky, it's now 28-21. Andrews Pinner, a 66-yard run to make that a one-touchdown game. And Penn State, Larry Johnson on a 15-yard block punt by Omar Easy. Well, don't forget, coming up, the Home Depot SEC on CBS. It's Mississippi State against Florida. You enjoy the game.
Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Original Coors, Samsung, Papa John's, and by Mercedes-Benz.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks, guys. See you tomorrow, all right?
Lunch is over. Buy a Coors Light?
Sold.
Sold? Now that's music to this banker's ears.
Listen, I've already offered a lot more than this little bar is worth.
I'm not selling. Build your condos around us.
I don't get it. What makes this dive so special?
This bar's packed every night with people who love the Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light.
Rocky Mountain Cold? Whatever. Hey, move to Colorado. I want this place. Nobody's gonna stop me. Not you or your beer.
Bartow.
The Duke?
I'll ask the questions. What time is it?
Time for me to leave.
And?
Coors Light's on me.
Here you go.
Okay, I had that coming.
Next round's on the Duke.
Like hell it is.
So, how's the food here?
Great, Mom. Pizza every day.
That's what I was afraid of.
Oh, it's not what you had in college, Mom. It's Papa John's.
But you need variety.
Variety? I get it with Papa John's thin or original crust, great fresh veggies, and 100% meat toppings. And right now, a large two-topping Papa John's pizza is only $9.99. Plus, a second large two-topping pizza is just $4.99. I'm living better than I ever did at home.
It's amazingly clear. It's multifunctional. High definition television from Samsung. It's a world of clarity, and everyone's invited. Come to Sears every Saturday to see a live broadcast of college football in high definition.
This game is simulcast in high definition by Samsung, inviting you to discover the clarity of HD TV.
The only thing Florida coach Steve Spurrier hates more than losing is being embarrassed. And last season, the Mississippi State Bulldogs hung a humiliating defeat on Spurrier and the Gators.
Sets up and throws. Touchdown! Look at this scene in Starkville.
These Bulldogs are hungry for more and want to take another bite out of Gators' hide.
but dogs beware. The Gators are primed for payback, and the main ingredient for sweet revenge is a little home cooking. Welcome to the Swamp. It's Mississippi State versus Florida.